Hi there, Reece Toscani here from fireplaceproducts.co.uk, here today to talk to you about air controls on woodburning stoves. There's lots of different ways of controlling air on a stove, and a lot of stoves have different ways of doing that with primary, secondary, tertiary air, and different controls top, bottom, underneath. So we're going to try and sort of wade through the different variants and show you some options. So come inside and we'll get started. So first off, I'm going to show you this, the Piazzetta ME9070. Now on this stove, it's a big built-in stove, big slide-up glass door. Air controls on this is slightly different to other stoves, but this is a really good example of showing you the difference between a stove and an open fire. Now with this stove, I can open the door. Now you can see straight away, by opening the door, sudden influx of air going straight into the stove that pushes heat straight out, but the fire is now burning uncontrollably. There's no regulation. We've got no sliders or controls that allow us to regulate how much air is being introduced and how hot the fire is burning. So by doing this, yes, you're going to get a lovely flame, but you're removing the efficiency from the fire. And that's why we use a woodburning stove. Okay, so here we have the Aarrow Ecoburn Plus 11 multifuel stove. Now, with this stove, this has the more traditional and probably the most common system of air introduction. So we've got the primary air control at the bottom of the stove here, which is a slider left to right, and we also have the secondary air at the top, which again, slider left to right. What this is doing is injecting air through the door, underneath the grates, and up to the fuel. You can obviously change the setting on this when you go to wood, as we have it, and it will divert it around the grate and put it over the top of the fuel for burning logs. That's better. And then the top air control is taking air in through these slots at the top and then pushing it down through this little gap at the top here, is then pushing that cool air down the glass and then feeding that back into the fire. So we slide the primary, that starts to throttle that down. And then when we adjust the secondary, again, quite dramatic. Now, the varying degrees of how dramatic that flame reduction is really goes to the quality of the stove that you've purchased and how much money you've spent. Typically, if you're buying a good brand, such as the Aarrow, such as the Scan, the Barbas, any of the other stoves that we've featured today, you're paying, what you're paying for is that control of air and how responsive it is to the air control touch. You'll find on some of the cheaper stoves at the lower end of the spectrum, around the sort of £400 mark, that you'll do these with your air controls, and while it is adjusting the amount of air, you just don't see the dramatic effect like that. It will take 5 to 10 minutes before you actually see that reduction in flame. Whereas on, you know, on a slightly more expensive stove, slightly better built, better quality, the air controls are a lot more tight, a lot sealed, and you can see that reduction almost immediately. Slide this back up. And again, you'll see that will take no time at all, and then get back to where it was. So the stove we've got here is the Scan 64-1, and this operates using two air controls, both located at the bottom. We've got the primary air control here, and secondary air control there. Now primary air is air injected at the base of the stove, so it's air coming up from the bottom. Secondary air is air coming in from the top. A lot of stoves have the primary at the bottom of the stove and the secondary at the top of the stove. That is a traditional combustion, which puts cool air in from the secondary down the glass and back into the firebox. This particular stove has preheated secondary air, or preheated air washers, it's also known. What that's doing is taking the air in from underneath the stove, pushing it up the back, across the top, warming on its way through, and then down the glass. Let me show you on this stove, you can see the difference. So if we adjust the primary air control first, now because the secondary is fully open at the moment, it's not as dramatic. If I shut the secondary down, you'll see a dramatic change in the flame. That's almost instant. Putting that out. We've got a little bit of air trickling in at the back through the pilot air. On the sand stoves that come with pilot air, that just injects air to get the fire going. You also see these flames that are just appearing in the middle of the firebox, that's the hydrocarbons burning, so that's the tertiary air, the holes at the back of the stove, injecting fresh oxygen into the firebox as it's burning, and that's the oxygen in that burning off without any other air controls coming in. Now if I open up the primary air, you see right at the bottom there, kickstarts back in, all from the bottom. See the air coming up and those logs burning again. Now if I shut that one down, that'll kill that off again. And I do the same with the secondary.
I'm just asking your opinion.
You see again at the higher level where that oxygen is now being brought in from the top, kickstarts. Reopen the primary again, and the whole thing comes back to life. Let's have a look at that on another one. Okay, here, so we have the Barbas Quattro 375 cassette stove. Now, a cassette stove, although looking slightly different, the control of air is predominantly the same. On this particular fire, it's one single air control, located underneath at the bottom here. Rather than having a control at the top and a control at the bottom, this one control puts air in from the primary at the bottom and also from the secondary at the top. As well as that, we also have the tertiary, which is coming through the slots at the back fire brick there too. So at the moment it's on full. As I slide this across, we'll start to see the air being removed from the firebox, so it's being cut down the supply, and you start to see that flame slowly start to die down. So the primary has been cut, the secondary has been cut, and the tertiary is always the last one. So that's why you see the fire is not really burning around the logs at the moment, it's all just burning around the air control, air supply coming in back on that tertiary. That's why you get these lovely plumes of flame coming straight out of those holes on the back fire brick. Now again, by sliding this back up, you can see the dramatic effect that the introduction of air has on the firebox and getting the flame back and getting the firebox back up to temperature. Okay, so at the other end of the scale we've got the Hwam here, the 3630 model. Now with this stove it actually comes with the Hwam autopilot technology. So what that is it's a self-regulating biometric coil inside the stove that depending on the outputs and the heat temperature of the stove opens and closes the primary and secondary air. So it's self-regulating. So none of the controls, you know, adjusting the primary, adjusting the secondary, not sure which one you need to do at the time. The stove knows how much air it needs and gives itself that air. You can bypass this with an air control around the back, but predominantly slide that up to start it and then just shut that down when you're finished, when you want to go to bed at night. But otherwise, that's it, you don't have to touch it. So this is essentially the future of air controls on woodburning stoves, so there's no human input required. Well, I've been Reece Toscani for fireplaceproducts.co.uk. Thank you very much for watching this video on air controls on woodburning stoves. Thank you.